Okay, in this video we're going to look at this proposition which has something to do with the Laplace transformation of the derivative of a function. So let's recall first that if we have a function f, its Laplace transform, which we denote by this calligraphic LF, is the integral from 0 to infinity of f of t e to the minus st dt, and we often denote that by f of s with a capital F. And so what we have here is that if we have this technical consideration on this limit as t goes to infinity of f of t e to the minus st is equal to 0 for s bigger than s0, then we have the Laplace transform of f prime is equal to negative f evaluated at 0 plus s times the Laplace transform of f of t. And so, and this should say that this holds for s bigger than s0. Okay, so let's go ahead and look at the proof. It's fairly, it's a fairly simple application of integration by parts. So what we'll do is look at the Laplace transform of f prime of t. But notice, by the definition, this is the integral from 0 to infinity of f prime of t e to the minus st dt. And so now we're going to use integration by parts, like I alluded to. We're going to take u equal to e to the minus st, and we're going to take dv equal to f prime dt. Okay, great. But now notice that's going to make du equal to minus s e to the minus st dt, and that's going to make v equal f of t. So now when we plug this into our integration by parts formula, notice what we get. We get u times v, so that's going to be equal to f of t e to the minus st, and now we're evaluating that from 0 to infinity. Good. And then we're going to subtract v du, but notice du has a minus built in, so that means that's going to turn into addition. We can factor the s out because that's a constant with respect to this t integral. And now we have the integral from 0 to infinity of f of t e to the minus st dt. Now notice that this bit right here is just exactly s times the Laplace transform of our original function f of t. Good. Now notice, if we plug infinity in, that's the same thing as taking a limit. But notice, taking a limit, well, we decided that that limit was equal to 0. That's part of the hypotheses of this result. So that part's going to go to 0. Now if we plug 0 into this, we're going to get e to the 0, which is 1, and we're going to get f of 0. But notice this is the second bound of integration, so that's going to be attached to a minus sign. So we have minus f of 0 plus s times the Laplace transform of the original function, and that's the end of the proof of this proposition.